Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the last episode for this year for Cooking with Kurt. Of course, it is summertime, it is barbecue time, and I would like to conclude my this year's Cooking with Kurt cooking school with a barbecue, which is a little bit different than regular barbecues that you may know. We will do today a fish barbecue, and we will do a minced lamb kebab, and we will do a chicken. The fish barbecue is an Asian preparation, and I will tell you, it is wonderful, okay? You will be very pleased with this dish when you make it at home. Very easy to do, not difficult at all. The same with the lamb, which is more like a Mediterranean preparation. With Greek yogurt and mint and lamb, of course, and you will see the preparation when I do it. Very, very tasty. You can use this as a main course, you can use this as an appetizer, or even on a smaller version as a canapé. And the third preparation will be a preparation from Georgia, Russia, not Georgia, United States. It's a chicken, it's quite a famous chicken actually. Original name is Chicken Tabaga. It is a small type of chicken, like a Cornish hen would be comparable, okay? And it is made on the barbecue, cooked on the barbecue rather, a butterfly, as you will see in a moment, and with a heavy weight on it, okay? And I will explain it a little bit further. Okay, so I hope you will have fun with those dishes at home, entertaining your friends and yourself. And enjoy the summer. We have a short summer here in Ottawa, and we should make the most of it. And those dishes definitely will help you to enjoy it. Bon appétit in advance, and I will be with you in a moment. Thank you. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, now this is the last of the barbecue segment. As you can see here, we have a tiny chicken, which is also called a Cornish hen. And it's a recipe from Georgia in Russia. It's a very famous recipe there, or dish rather. Every street corner sells it, okay? And what they do is they take the chicken, they cut it in the back, they open it, like this here, which is called butterfly. We take the bones out, like this over here, and then we season the chicken just with coarse salt. A little bit more. Kosher salt. Same thing on top. We put a touch of cayenne only on the skin side. We take some olive oil again, not extra virgin, just olive oil. We turn it around, same thing again. We need to be careful that we don't put too much oil, because the barbecue will flame up and then you may have a burnt chicken, or at least not a very nice colored chicken, okay? So we have the oil there. We take some napkin, a clean napkin, and now we take off a little bit the oil, like this, and we put it on the barbecue. And as I mentioned to you before, first we put the skins at the meat side down, okay? And again we put the weight on it, okay? We put the weight on the chicken, and it will again do two things. Number one, it will cook faster, the chicken will cook faster, and it will retain the moisture. And my Georgian friends told me that and I didn't believe them first, but I tried it myself, and sure enough, it's true. Okay, you will see the chicken is much more moist than if it's cooked just regularly. Okay, you can also enjoy this chicken, especially in the Russian section in New York. They have some chicken roasters like this, and again, the name is Chicken Tabaga. Don't forget that when you go to New York next time. All right. For this particular dish, you can serve almost anything. You can serve roasted potatoes, mashed potatoes, French fries, salads. Today I made a little bit plum compote. You can serve a plum compote with that, which always goes good with chicken. Any kind of fruit compote goes good with chicken. And if you do this on the barbecue at home, I'm sure your friends will come back quite often. Okay, so here we have the, I have already some chicken which I made before. As you can see here, this is how it looks like once it's made. Okay, what I will do is, in order for it to be cooked properly, we will take the chicken when it's almost cooked off. We dissect the breast and we put the legs back, because the legs take a little bit longer than the breast. As you can see here, we have the, we check it a little bit. It's not quite cooked, but it's not quite ready to be turned, you know, but we will make the presentation in a moment, and I will show you the chicken on the barbecue once it's ready, in about 4 or 5 minutes. Okay, as you can see, we have the chicken now on the barbecue. We take it off from the barbecue. I wish the barbecue would have been a little bit hotter. But it's actually quite nice. We put the chicken on here. I also have a little bit chives. Chives with butter, garlic. And we put some lemon juice in here. And we pour this over the chicken. And this is a wonderful dish for the summer. And you will see once you serve this, you put a little bit of watercress on over here. We have some plums. You can use any fruit, peaches, plums, nectarines. And all you do is you just peel, you don't have to peel them even. You half them, take the pit out, some sugar, a little bit vinegar, saute, put the plums in with a little bit cinnamon and cook it until this is, has this consistency. Wonderful accompaniment for chicken, fish, almost anything in the summertime. Okay, so as you can see here, we have those three dishes. We will show them in a moment again. And I hope you enjoy this little cooking course, little bit barbecue with a difference. Nevertheless, I believe you will be very happy with the results once you follow the instruction exactly, okay? Not really, you can improvise. Thank you very much, and I will see you at the next season with Cooking with Kurt. Thank you.